song.
Classic 4th of July
favorite
song.
Patriotic song.
You know, we were talking about what we did on the 4th, and, and Melissa was just on the phone with her husband. I'm going to tell the dog peeing story. Tune in, about to talk about the peeing
it's
dog.
A good tease, isn't it?
I'm getting a kick out of it. Can
what?
I tell you?
Yeah,
I'm still fired up about this. So we had like a block party in front of our house, and we're all enjoying things. It was my dog Norm's 4th birthday yesterday. He has the 4th of July birthday. So anyway, I have dog birthday cake. I've got doggy goodie bags. I have everything. And somebody who knows one of the people there walks up with their dog, who is like a really tall, big dog. This dog looks at us, walks over to my little boy's toys, as well as my brand new huge digital camera and my little brand new video camera, lifts his leg, pees on everything.
You've dog pee.
Fire could have been coming out of every orifice of my body. I was furious.
I don't blame you.
Furious. And the girl's like, sorry.
It wasn't even
the
sorry.
The dog just
no sincere
hiked and peed on everything.
Thanks for the demonstration.
It's like $2,000 worth. You know what I mean? Like,
that's
I mean,
ridiculous.
They were gifts to me, but it doesn't matter.
That lady owes you a new camera.
So I got
I
her
think
information.
So.
Oh, did
yes,
you?
I
if
did.
You're watching, ma'am,
good
please control
you.
Your
hopefully
dog.
She is, because she's still not.
And now if she's watching, she's got to get your new camera now.
Exactly.
You don't want the animosity in your neighborhood.
Anyway, all right, I'm okay now.
You're all right?
I feel better.
Good.
Because she can't, like, talk
and you vented now.
I'm just telling you what I think.
You should have gone with me last night. I was at the Dick's Sporting Goods Park.
You had fun.
I did. Did you see the fireworks from Dick's Sporting Goods Park last night? It's beautiful.
I saw the video.
It rained. For half the game, it rained.
Oh.
Now, you know, I'm not a big soccer guy. I was there last night when the Rapids took on the New York Red Bulls, and I didn't realize that soccer, it's my first soccer game ever. 90 minutes of play, and they only scored one goal.
No one
you
told you ahead
there
of time?
Did you realize there was a ball?
Well, yes, because it goes back and forth,
yeah,
and nobody
run their
scores.
Tails off.
They work hard, but nothing happens. So next time, here's an idea. Instead of going to the game, I'm going to do this next time I want to go, because it's equally exciting.
I'm actually going to sit here and watch this paint dry for 10 minutes.
Paint dry.
Ouch.
Look, that's a lot like the game last night. There we go.
And these people invited you to their game. I'm assuming they're not going to invite you again next year.
I'm only kidding. The truth is I had a great time. And actually, I am kind of hooked. The game was fun.
Mm-hmm.
It's a low-scoring game, mind you, but it's fun.
Give more respect to soccer moms, huh?
And you might meet Maynard there at the game, too.
Yeah,
my friend meets the mayor and calls him Maynard. All right, so are you team Edward or are you team Jacob?
Edward.
Edward?
I don't even really know the difference.
I don't really.
Vampire or wolf?
Wolf.
Okay, so you're Team Jacob. Either way, these guys are making in tons of money, so you could date either one of them. We now know today how much the lead actors are getting for the next films. They're going to get $50 million apiece.
Retire.
Just for shooting the last two movies. $25 million a picture.
Wait, shooting the last two movies? I thought they're only...
There's one, they're making
four
a,
books.
Yeah, but they're making the last one into two movies.
Really?
They are.
Oh, I didn't
That's
know that.
That's old news, girlfriend. Oh. They're also going to get 7% of the theater revenue, which could boost their total take for these last two films to $80 million. That just boggles my mind.
That's crazy.
Unreal.
Goodness.
Cash in while you can, I guess. Right?
Yeah.
I know.
Hey,
hopefully they won't blow it.
No, $80 bucks. I'd love a shot at blowing all that money. Hope you were out celebrating your freedom yesterday, because tomorrow it may be an orange jumpsuit and bumming cigarettes in the jail yard. Don't believe me? Ask Lindsay Lohan. She might go to the slammer. You ever known anybody who served jail time?
You served a little bit.
You and then
there's... No, mine was work release. Here's the deal. She's missed her last three alcohol ed classes, and she missed a court appearance because she was in Europe and lost her passport. Tomorrow's court appearance, we're told she could very well have to go to jail. I'll keep you posted. You guys know from my soccer story that I am a huge sports fan, but I'm also a fan of Betty White. And now my two worlds have become one, because Betty White, who is in the cast of Hot in Cleveland, is now weighing in on the LeBron James issue, trying to get LeBron to stay with the Cavaliers. Take a look.
Maybe he's an ice skater.
Oh, look at us. We're like a sports bar in here.
What's wrong with you girls? He's the best basketball player on the planet.
LeBron, please stay.
I'll make it worth your while.
Huh? Hello there. Who wouldn't stay for one night with Betty White?
That sounds like a show in itself.
Yeah. All right, and we're talking about the soccer games. I believe that what would have jazzed up last night's soccer game would be if the players had choreographed all their moves to Lady Gaga. It's just a suggestion, don't you think?
Why not?
Rah, rah, oh, la, la.
As long as they wear those costumes.
Yeah, that'd be great. Oh, I'd go to every game if that were the case. Lady Gaga is now the biggest living star ever on Facebook. She has more fans than any living being. On Saturday, she surpassed the 10 million fan mark, eclipsing even President Barack Obama.
She has a little video I saw on her Facebook page, because I read that as well, and she has a video that says thank you to all the fans, and it was a cute little
We're her little monsters, is what we are. She's coming, by the way, to Denver a little later in the month.
Yeah.
Well, I know when you were out there yesterday celebrating your fourth, you most likely sang the Star Spangled Banner, didn't you? I mean, it was everywhere you go. It's part of our national tradition, but I hope you sang it better than these guys. Billboard coming out with the worst anthem performances ever. Now, quickly, number five was Aaron Neville at the Super Bowl.
Okay.
Number four was Scott Stapp of Creed back at the NASCAR 400.
I
didn't see that one either. Hmm. Number three was Michael Bolton back in 2003 when he read it off of his palm.
Yeah.
Sarah Palin style.
That's a rocket.
The number two, worst ever anthem as described by Billboard magazine, you know her and you love her. And the crowd goes crazy.
And then she spits.
Yeah, that's a class act right there, Roseanne. Class act. But you know what? Even worse than Roseanne, according to Billboard, the worst ever performance of the national anthem goes to Kat DeLuna back in 2008 at the Dallas Cowboys game. She did so much embellishing, the crowd is going to boo her here, and her entire career tanked. Take a listen. They booed her off stage.
That would hurt your career a bit.
Just a little.
She added a line. You can't do that.
You can't add a line to the national anthem. What is she thinking? We are patriotic on this program. We love the red, white, and blue on this program so much so that when we saw Huffington Post list the most patriotic celebrities, we thought we had to show it to you. Here is their number one most patriotic celeb. Well, she's decked out. Look, it's Lady Gaga.
Oh, yeah.
Hello, hello. It's from her telephone video.
Love that video still.
Betsy Ross wore that same outfit when she helped George with the flag. And then the honorable mention, this is my favorite photo of the day. Say hello to Will Ferrell showing his pride in the U.S. of A, baby.
Love that skit from Saturday Night Live way back. Hilarious. So wrong.
That's what I wore to pool yesterday. Don't judge me. Don't judge me.
The flag banana hammock?
Uh-huh.
Isn't that what they call it?
I am sitting next to two of the most beautiful women in Colorado. That's no joke. I mean, you gals are gorgeous.
He wants something new.
No, I think you could both be America's next top model.
I'm out of cash. I'm sorry.
I'm saying you could be a model. Don't you think? And so could you at home. You remember Nicole Fox from Colorado?
Uh-huh.
She won last season.
So beautiful.
Yeah. Here's your chance now. Producers are casting for season 15, and you could audition right here in Denver. Cycles open for women 18 to 27 who are at least 5'7", and we're hosting that casting call next Saturday at Denver Pavilions. You can download all the info on our website. Go to tothedeuce.com/everyday, and we'll link you with everything you need to know to become America's next top model.
You could be it. We could use another Colorado winner.
I know. Another
be good stuff, wouldn't it?
Nicole was my absolute favorite of
she
that
She was
whole
so
show.
Sweet, too. We talked for a bunch.
Yeah,
she was great.
She was really sweet.
All right, it's 10.